Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to The Edit Place. Today, we are talking about how to choose what editing app is right for you. Nowadays, there are an abundance of apps out there, ranging from free apps you can download to your phone to professional NLEs like Adobe Premiere, DaVinci Resolve, Avid, and so much more in between. So in this video, I want to ask you a couple questions that will hopefully lead you to a much more educated decision on which app you should spend your time and potentially money with. Biggest and most important question is, what is your kind of end goal, or at least your decently going forward goal as a creator? Do you just love busting out short form content for TikTok and IG? Do you want to slowly refine your skills to do short films or YouTube or corporate wedding event work? Let's first go down the path of the person who likes the short form content like TikTok and IG Reels. What creative style do you really like? Because the creators on that platforms that are doing skits or more like narrative based story stuff, and you can just tell that their stuff is really high quality. They may even be potentially using a dedicated camera instead of their phone. For these, I'd recommend really going towards one of the more professional NLEs, which we'll talk to in a few minutes. But for the people who really just, you know, love grabbing your phone and you like putting it out there in a relatively speedy manner, I suggest you find a mobile app that you really like. If you literally search video editing in the App Store, you have Splice. I've used that one, that one's good. CapCut, iMovie, which I believe is free for any iPhones or iPads. Video Leap, I've used that a bunch, as well as Michelle has, and I know she likes it. LumaFusion is even on the iPhone, but LumaFusion I think falls more in line with the apps we're gonna talk about in a few minutes. The reason that these apps are totally fine is because you are looking for speed, efficiency, and a decent set of features that are specifically built for the platforms that you will be posting your content on. All of these apps know that you are not a professional editor by trade, so they're going to make importing footage, rearranging, cutting up, adding graphics, adding music as simple as possible. You may not have the most advanced controls, but that's going to give you a much more simplified, pleasant, and kind of straightforward experience. Now, in my opinion, a lot of these apps are charging way too much and abusing the whole like subscriber phenomena. But if you find an app that you really like that has features you really like, I don't think there's any real reason that you have to go above and beyond in terms of new software, unless you start to develop a real passion for this stuff and you want to go more into the other type of content creation, which we're going to talk about, which is, again, whether you're going short form or long form on various platforms, but you really want to like cut things together and kind of create an edit that is a little bit more advanced than just starting and stopping recording in various places that you would do on like TikTok. For anyone going down this road, I strongly recommend you go with a professional NLE. Anyone who knows me knows that I'm going to very biasedly say DaVinci Resolve. Why am I biased? It's certainly not because I'm paid by Blackmagic. They don't pay any creator. They don't sponsor people like that. It's for two reasons. One, I think they are by far the best video editing platform out right now. Adobe Premiere has a lot of great features. They have a lot of good market share. And if you're going to work with a lot of video production companies and that's kind of your end goal, then sure. I mean, you can ask where you hope to apply to work and you can ask what they use. And then it's smart to kind of learn their systems. But DaVinci Resolve has a free version that has about 95% of the same features as the studio version. And even when you buy the studio version, it's incredibly inexpensive in terms of comparing it to something like Premiere Pro. It's a one-time buy of $299. But if you buy a Blackmagic camera, a speed editor, which also is $299, you get DaVinci Resolve Studio for free included. So it's basically a $300 value with a $300 hardware product. So it's priced incredibly fairly. And you get an experience that I think both beginner video editors can really grasp hold of within a couple of hours, to being able to literally edit a Hollywood blockbuster. Because yes, Hollywood blockbusters are edited in DaVinci Resolve sometimes. Now, why would I recommend jumping into a complicated program like DaVinci Resolve to someone who is a new editor? Honestly, the biggest reason is because I constantly see the struggle of changing softwares. Heck, I went through it. I've jumped ship from all the various softwares. I started in Sony Vegas, then I went to Premiere, then I went to Final Cut, then I went back to Premiere for a bit, and then a handful of years ago, I adopted DaVinci Resolve. And because I've bounced around to them all, I know that they all are very similar, actually, with how their setups are. I've made a bunch of videos on that. But I see so many people on social media be like, oh, I really like the look of X software, and I know it's probably technically better for me, but I've just been using whatever existing software for over a decade. I don't have the time to make the switch. Because our muscle memory, once you become an efficient editor, you don't even think about your program. You and the program become one. And so it's really hard to switch. And so I personally think it's worth it to just download the free version of DaVinci Resolve, open it up, have that 30 seconds of like, oh my God, this all looks way overwhelming. Watch a couple free tutorials from Blackmagic's own website. I have a very inexpensive course on getting started with DaVinci Resolve where you can ask me questions directly. I'm just saying, it's down in the description below. And truly, after just a handful of hours, even less than that, honestly, within 1 hour of just sitting down and familiarizing yourself with the layout, and oh, this is where I import footage, this is where I see the footage, this is where I edit the footage. Everything else is just gonna come over time. And so if you start early in a professional editing software, after a year, you are going to be astronomically ahead of the person who says, okay, for the first like 6 to 8 months, I'm gonna go into like iMovie or LumaFusion or some basic program, learn that, get good at that, and then okay, now it's time to jump to a real professional editing software, and now you download DaVinci Resolve and you're like, I gotta completely relearn an entirely new editing software. Now again, even if you wanna go with Premiere Pro or Final Cut, the reasons stay the same. It's not just for DaVinci Resolve. If you like Premiere and you start with that from day one, within a couple of hours, you're gonna be able to learn the program basics, and then over time, you will get better at learning the advanced stuff. You'll feel very comfortable. Because honestly, video editing is just pushing a bunch of very simple buttons. The hard part is actually knowing the psychology of editing, and that's the stuff that really takes years and years and years of practice. Hopefully this video helped you answer the question of which program you should use. If you guys have any pieces of software that you like to recommend that I didn't mention in this video, feel free to post the name and why you like it down in the comments below so we can all share our knowledge together. Thanks so much for watching. Let's get back to the edit.